Go to the top view by pressing the Z in the gizmo or number 7 in your numpad. Click Add, Curve, Bezier. While selected, go here in the Object Data Properties. Scroll down until you find the bevel category. Adjust the thickness of the curve by increasing the value of depth. It depends on you on how thick you want it to be. To manipulate the curve, go to Edit Mode. There are certain points here that you can move and extrude. I will extrude this point this way and adjust it a little bit. I'll also extrude this point here once again and another extrude to the last point. There. It's kind of easy actually, you don't need to be stressed out about it. You can also do other objects using the curve like hair, you just have to use your imagination and creativity. If you are okay with the ribbon's form, select all the points and move the whole object on the left side. After that, go here in the modifier properties and add mirror. Move it a little bit towards the center. Make some adjustments for the form of your ribbon according to your preference. If you're satisfied with your ribbon, we now need to convert it into a mesh. If we try to apply the mirror modifier, it will not be applied unless the curve is classified as a mesh. We cannot also join a curve to other parts of your objects unless it is converted to mesh. Take note of the symbol of the Bezier curve here in the outliner and see the difference. To convert the curve into a mesh, in object mode, right-click your object, convert to mesh. The symbol of the Bezier curve turned into an inverted triangle, which is the symbol for mesh. Now, when you go to edit mode, our ribbon now has its components that you can freely edit according to your style. Lastly, let's add the middle part of the ribbon. I will be using the torus mesh. Rotate it at an angle of negative 90 degrees. Then, I'm just gonna scale it based on its axis to fit the ribbon. I'll just unsubdivide the torus to save up some poly count because there are a lot of unused polygons here. In face select, right-click the torus, then choose unsubdivide. After that, in object mode, select all the objects and press Ctrl J to join them. Then, add a material to it so you can put your design. I will be using the default cube here, so let's just delete the camera and the light. Go to the front view and scale the cube to the x-axis and also on the y-axis. It will depend on you on how long and thick you want it to be. Go back to the front view and switch to edit mode. Add a loop cut in the middle, then subdivide it by 3 using the tab that appeared in the bottom left of our screens. Change the number of cuts to 3. We will add another mesh called torus. Go to add, mesh, torus. Rotate the torus in an angle of negative 90 degrees. Scale the torus up a bit. In edit mode, press Alt S and move your mouse to shrink the torus and scale it up again to adjust. The first thing we would do here is to add a keyframe. Expand the tab here below so you can have a good space for your workflow. On the very first frame, which is 0, I will add a keyframe by pressing I on the keyboard and then select scale. You will know you have successfully added a keyframe by the yellow dot on the 0 frame. Then somewhere along the 50th frame, I will scale the torus down, again based on my preference. Add another keyframe by pressing I again, then scale. So when we try to play it, it should be like this. It's shrinking. So if everything is okay, we can already add collision physics. Select the torus, go here in the physics properties, and select collision. Let's proceed to the cube. For the cube, we will add a cloth physics. So if I try to play this, it looks like this. However, it looks too blocky, so let's shade smooth the ribbon. Another problem arises because it looks like crumpled paper and it looks ugly. So go here in the modifier properties and add subdivision surface. As you can see, our mesh turned a lot smoother. We can increase the subdivision level to 2. However, we need to be conscious of our poly count, so let's just switch back to level 2. Even though we added a subdivision surface, there are still parts that look crumpled, so go back to the very first frame, and here on the modifier properties, I will place the subdivision surface to the very top of the modifiers. So the subdivision surface should be above the cloth physics. Let's play it again. I think it's better than before. However, look at what happened. It's too drippy. The way to fix this is to adjust the gravity of the area. So go back to the very first frame, physics properties, then scroll down to the field weights and expand it. Adjust the gravity to your preference. For me, it's 0.5. So let's play again. I think this is fine. A tip in cloth simulation is you can move the keyframe to find the angle that you want and stop whenever you are satisfied. So mine did not hit the 50th keyframe yet, but I stopped somewhere here. One last thing that I notice about is it's colliding with itself. So let's go here in the physics properties. Scroll down until you find the collisions tab and enable self-collision. So let's play once again. a lot better, right? So now, I am satisfied with this one, so I'll go here in the modifier properties and apply the subdivision surface and cloth modifier. Then, let's just manually adjust the parts where the cloth physics wasn't able to achieve. Go to edit mode, turn on the proportional editing, and use the move tool to adjust. So let me finish this first. Then, just like from the ribbon earlier, I'll just unsubdivide the torus because there are a lot of unused polygons here. In face select, right click the torus, then choose unsubdivide. After that, in object mode, select all the objects and press Ctrl and J to join them. Then add a material to it so you can put your design. After you made the ribbons, you can now export it as an FBX and import it to your other projects so you can join them with your other objects. That's it for this video. I hope you learned something new for today. See you in the next one. Bye!